Hi guys. In this session, we'll see how to start and stop the MongoDB, the different options to start up the MongoDB, and we also see how to start up MongoDB from the options configured in a file. And also we'll see how to stop the MongoDB, the different options for it. So the MongoDB server is started using running the MongoD executable. The MongoD executable has different configurable options. To view all the options, we can give the command MongoD-help from the command line. The most commonly used parameter or the value is the DB path. So by default, MongoDB in Linux operating system expect a directory that is /data/db as the data directory. But if you are starting more than one MongoD processes, then you cannot have the multiple processor or multiple server process use the same data directory. So you must have the different data directory for the different MongoD process. So in that case, if you wanted to have an alternative directory, then you have to create that directory first and then specify that path in the as an input for -db path. Say for example, MongoD -db path /u01. So that user1 will become the data directory. And also, when the MongoD process starts, it creates a log file called mongod.log in the data directory. This will prevent another MongoD process from using the same data directory. And by default, the MongoD will be using the port number 27017. But in case if you wanted to, in case this port number is already used, or if you wanted to start more than one MongoD server process, in that case, you can specify the different port using the -port option. So, for example, if I wanted to start MongoD server process from port number 1820, in that case, I can give MongoD -port space 1802. So that way, when you are starting multiple MongoD process, you can specify the different port number and different data directory so that there will not be any conflict. Apart from the these two parameters, that is -db path and the port number, there are other configurable parameters or options. The first one is log path. The log path will be useful when you wanted to redirect the output of the MongoD execution to a file instead of the command line. Normally, when you are executing the MongoD, the output of that execution will be displayed on the command prompt. Instead, like if you wanted to view it in later point, if you wanted to redirect to a log path, you can specify the log path location. If the file does not exist, then the file will get created. And the next parameter is the fork. Fork will indicate that MongoD will start as a daemon process. So it will be starting as a executable. The executable will be starting as a daemon process. And you will be able to see the port number as well. And the next parameter is directory per DB. Directory per DB indicates that each database will be created in its own directory. If you are leaving that parameter, then all the directories will be created under the single directory in the DB directory path or DB path. So what happens is that you have multiple databases are there, and you want the different databases to be created on different location. Say for example, you have a production database which is require a faster data read and write access, then you can a mount point created using the solid state disks, and you can specify that your DB path to that particular particular directory, and then you can specify directory per DB. In that case, each directory will be having its own each database will be having its own directory. And then next parameters are config parameter. Config parameter will help you to start the MongoDB from a configuration file using the options specified in a configuration file. In the previous examples and all, we have seen giving all the parameters on the command line. But if you wanted to start up MongoDB from a shell script, in that case, you can specify all the parameters in a configuration file and call that configuration file. And that will help you that another advantage is that when you're having that parameter specified in the configuration file and you use that configuration for file to start up the MongoDB, then every time the startup will use the same parameter. So your configurations will remain constant between the multiple restarts. So let's see an example where in which MongoDB is going to use a port number 5586 and sending all the output to mongodb.log. So here what happens is we are calling MongoDB hyphen port 5586 fork, which indicates that it will be starting as a daemon process, hyphen log path equal space mongodb.log. So the log file will be created on the current directory from which you are executing the MongoDB. Suppose if you wanted to specify the log path to a different directory, then you must give the fully qualified name. And here the log append is going to say that or it's indicate that the log file will get appended. So whenever the new restarts are happening, the existing log file will get added with the new information. Now we'll see how to start MongoDB based on the configuration file. So here I have created a configuration file with the information port 5586, fork equal to true, log path var log mongodb.log, log append equal to true. These are the same configuration parameter given in the previous slide. But here, now we are keeping this information on a log file. So sorry, on a configuration file. So let's see, let's assume that I have given this configurations to the path slash etc mongodb.conf. Now we are going to start up the MongoDB by giving the command MongoDB hyphen config space slash etc mongodb.conf, or else I can give another way, that is MongoDB hyphen f slash etc slash mongodb.conf. So this will be using the configuration file slash etc mongodb.conf file as a configuration file while the startup. Hope it's clear. And now we'll see how to stop the MongoDB. One of the commonly used or the cleanest way of shutting down the MongoDB is that use the shutdown command from the shell, that is MongoDB connect shell. So when you are giving this option, you must connect it to the admin database. So from the MongoDB client shell, we give the command use admin to use the admin database. And then we'll issue the command db shutdown server. This shutdown command will shut down the MongoDB server. Then if you are having a replication setup, then before shutting down the primary, MongoDB will wait till the secondary catches all the changes that happened on the primary. So the cleanest way of shutting down the MongoDB is that use the shutdown command from the Mongo shell by connecting to the admin database. Now the other two methods are you can kill the background, kill the process at the OS level by using kill hyphen 9 and the process number. Here you could in the previous example we have seen that MongoDB when it starts, it uses the it gives you a port number in a process ID, and use that process ID and you can kill the MongoDB. The other option is that you can use the if MongoDB is started as a foreground process. In that case, you can use the press the control and C command, C letter together, that control C, which will terminate the MongoDB process if it is running as a foreground process. Hope the session for the startup and shutdown the MongoDB is clear for you guys. In the next session, we'll be seeing how to connect it to MongoDB using a command shell. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Hope this
video was useful for you. If you have any questions on this topic, please send a mail to me. My mail ID is trainer@vaish.com. And please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. The link is given in the bottom of this window. We'll be releasing at least one video every week. And if you have any specific requirement, please send that requirement to trainer@vaish.com. We are happy to work on your requirement, and we'll be posting the video at the earliest. Once again, thanks a lot.